Hello everyone, we will continue with the type species Asterius rubens under phylum Echinodermata. In this presentation, we'll be looking into in detail the circulatory system of Asterius. Actually, a true blood vascular system, it is absent in echinoderms, and in them, the circulatory system, it is represented by a hemal system. Here you can see the hemal system. Which is enclosed within a perihemal system. So these two together, the hemal system enclosed in a perihemal system, it forms the circulatory system. Okay, a true blood vascular system is absent in starfishes. So we'll see the structure over here. Okay. So the one which is marked in the red, it represents the hemal system. Okay, you can see over here. Okay, this is the oral surface and this is the aboral surface. And you can see this is the ring canal, which we have already mentioned under water vascular system. Okay, so the ring canal, and this one, it is the stone canal over here and the madreporite. Okay, these are the structures of water vascular system. Okay, just below the ring canal, you can see the ring over here surrounding the base of the esophagus, very close to the mouth region, right? And this represents the hemal perihemal system, the part of the hemal perihemal system of the oral surface, oral side. Okay, then over here you can see yet another ring, this closer to the the central aboral surface of the central disc, and this is again part of the hemal perihemal system. And there is yet another structure, a part of the hemal perihemal system which interconnects these two. Okay, so this is what actually is represented by the hemal and perihemal system. Okay, we will see in detail what are the structure parts. Okay, I hope the position, the location is clear to you. Okay, right. Coming to the hemal system, we can see, so it's all marked in green over here. We can start it from the oral surface. Okay. So the hemal system, it is greatly reduced, and it consists of intercommunicating sinuses. Okay, so what are sinuses? Sinuses, they are channels filled with synovic fluid which contains coelomocytes. Okay, so the sinuses, they are simply channels with the coelomic fluid which contains the coelomocytes in them. Okay, and coelomocytes are responsible for the transportation of various substances. Okay. So, what about over here? You can see the first one. Okay, this dark colored part is the hemal system, the part of the hemal system. So, here you can see the oral hemal ring. Okay, that is the first one, right? Oral hemal ring. It is the circular hemal sinus located around the mouth just below the ring canal, okay, of the water vascular system. Okay, so this is the ring shaped or the circular hemal sinus is the ring, oral hemal ring. Okay, now starting off from here, arising from the oral hemal ring, radially you can find the radial hemal sinuses or radial hemal strands. Okay, each arm receives one radial hemal strand. Okay, so the radial hemal strand, it radiates or arises radially from the oral hemal ring, and one, each one, there are five, and each one extends to each of the arm, okay, along the floor of the ambulacral groove just below the radial canal of the water vascular system. So the oral hemal ring was just below the ring canal, while the here you can see the radial hemal canal, it is just below the radial canal of the water vascular system. Okay, and at each tube feet, the radial hemal canal, it sends off branches to the tube feet. Okay, now coming to the next part. Okay, this one over here, it is associated with the stone canal of the water vascular system, and this part, the part of the hemal system, it is referred as an axial gland. And this is the most important part of the hemal system, and it is usually referred as the heart. We are speaking about the circulatory system, isn't it? Even though the Asterius doesn't have any specific well-defined blood vascular system or the circulatory system, here the axial gland is considered to be the heart. Okay, and this axial gland, it remains enclosed within the axial sinus. You can see over here, axial sinus, it is a part of the coelomic, this one, the coelom, right? So axial sinus is a part of the cerebrum which encloses the axial gland inside. Okay, now the axial gland, it is connected with the oral as well as the aboral hemal sinuses. You can see this is the oral hemal sinus. Similarly, there is aboral hemal sinus along the aboral surface. Okay, and from its aboral end, you can see here. Okay, right. So from the aboral end, you can see a small terminal head process arises. Okay, a terminal head process, and this runs along the stone canal, and it is enclosed within a within dorsal sac, which is yet another coelomic sac. Okay, so a the axial gland at the aboral end, it you can see from the aboral end of the axial gland arises a small terminal head process, and this runs along the stone canal, and is it gets enclosed within a coelomic sac. It is the dorsal sac, right? And it is located below the madreporite. I hope you remember the structure of madreporite. Okay. Now, another structure associated with the axial gland is a pair of gastric duct. Okay, the gastric ducts. So here you can see this is the here this is where the dorsal sac and the terminal head process is located. Okay, so the gastric tuft is they are a pair in a pair of gastric tufts. They arise from the hemal sinus in the wall of the cardiac stomach and opens into the axial gland. You can see here that so axial gland, it receives a pair of gastric tufts. Okay, and it represents the hemal system. Okay, digested food from the stomach, it passes into the hemal circulation through this gastric duct. Okay, so gastric duct, it can be considered as a channel which receives the nutrients from the digested food from the cardiac stomach region or the pyloric stomach region, and it is then these nutrients are then channeled through the gastric duct into the hemal system. Okay, so we can see the oral hemal ring, the radial hemal strands of sinuses. Then we have the axial gland. Okay, the axial gland towards the aboral end, it extends as terminal head process, and it also receives a pair of gastric tufts. Okay, so now we have reached the aboral surface. We can find the pentagonal, almost pentagonal shaped ring over here, isn't it? And this one, it is known as the aboral hemal ring. Okay, so it is a pentagonal ring canal. It lies just beneath the aboral surface of the central disc, and from this canal you can see five pairs of genital strands. Okay, these strands inside, they are known as genital hemal strands. Okay, these genital hemal strands, they are paired, and it arises from the angles of the the aboral hemal ring. Okay, it is pentagonal in nature, as already mentioned. Okay, and it extends into the gonads. So these structures, bulbar structures, they are gonads, and these genital hemal strands, it extends into the gonads. Okay, so there are five pairs. So altogether, we have 10 strands, genital hemal strands. Okay, now what is the function of the hemal system? The hemal system, it acts as a pathway for the distribution of food substances carried by the coelomocytes. Actually, as already mentioned, the food, the digested food, the nutrients, it is taken up from the stomach region through the gastric tuft. It enters the hemal system, isn't it? And the hemal system, it distributes these nutrients to various parts of the body, and this is done with the help of the coelomocytes present in the coelomic fluid of the hemal system. Okay, so the flow of the fluid, it is maintained by the contractile cavity of the dorsal sac over here. Right, now the axial gland, it also acts as, so one function is distribution of the nutrients. Now the second one, the axial gland, that acts as a genital stolon. Okay, it produces the sex cells, and from the sex cells produced by the axial gland, it moves along the coelomic fluid, and it reaches the gonads through the genital hemal strands. Okay, so it passes through the aboral hemal ring, the genital hemal strand, and it gets deposited in the gonads. Okay, so this is the function, these are the functions of the hemal system. Okay, now perihemal system, what is it? Perihemal system, it is actually derived from the coelom, that is, it is a part of the coelom. Okay, and again, it also just like the hemal system, it consists of a system of tubular sinuses or vessels. Or the only difference is the perihemal system, it encloses the hemal system. Okay, that is, it encloses the sinuses of the hemal system. Fine, except you can see this one, the gastric duct part. Okay, except this one, all other parts of the hemal system, it is enclosed within the channels of the perihemal system. The first one over here, you can see the oral or hyponeural ring sinus. Okay, oral perihemal ring sinus or hyponeural ring sinus. It actually encloses the hemal, the oral hemal ring. Over here, you can see the oral hemal ring. It is enclosed by the oral perihemal or hyponeural ring sinus. Okay, so it encloses the oral hemal ring, right? Now, the next one we have is a radial perihemal canal or radial perihemal sinuses, and that encloses the radial hemal strand inside. Okay, and it runs into each of the arm, right? Now, the next one we have is this one, isn't it? Associated with the axial gland. As already mentioned, axial sinus, it encloses the axial gland of the hemal system. Okay, but axial sinus also encloses the stone canal. When we're talking about the water vascular system, we saw that the axial sinus encloses axial gland as well as the stone canal inside, and the complex formed of these three together, it is known as the axial complex. Okay, now the axial sinus, it forms a small dorsal sac at the aboral site, isn't it? And this encloses the terminal head process of the axial gland. Okay, so the dorsal sac is also a part of the perihemal system. As already mentioned, this is located just below the madreporite region. So this is where the madreporite can be found on the aboral surface. The axial sinus opens into the aboral perihemal ring sinus on the aboral surface. Okay, it encloses the aboral hemal ring inside. Okay, now genital hemal strands, it is being enclosed by a part of the perihemal system which is referred as genital perihemal sinuses. Okay, genital perihemal sinuses, right? Then we have the marginal sinuses and peribranchial sinuses. The marginal sinuses, they are 10 in number, 2 in each arm and 1 on each side below the marginal nerve cord opening into the radial perihemal sinus. Okay, the radial perihemal sinus of each of the arm receives the marginal sinuses of that particular arm. Okay, then the last one we have is the peribranchial sinus. Peribranchial sinus, it is circular sinuses found around the basal parts of the papillae. Now, what was papillae? Papillae is a dermal branchiae. Okay, dermal branchiae, which is involved in respiratory system in gaseous exchange in respiration. Okay, so peribranchial sinuses, they are circular sinuses which are found associated with the basal parts of the dermal branchiae. Okay, so this is about the circulatory system. So we already saw the circulatory system, it is formed of hemal system, which is enclosed within the perihemal system, and we saw how the coelomic fluid containing the coelomocytes help in the distribution of the nutrients across the body. Okay, so this is about the circulatory system. Fine. Yeah, thank you.